In this video, we're going to look at the content library within your class notebook in your Microsoft team. So within my sandbox, I default like usual to the general channel. From here, I'm going to click on class notebook at the top of the page here. And when I go to class notebook, remember this is where it's created a OneNote for you. So to get to the content library, depending on the size of your screen, it might be hidden. But if you click on the little caret at the upper left corner, we're going to go ahead and open that, and I get to the content library page here. So within the content library, it puts a page in here for using the content library. So in this video, it's going to be pretty short, so we won't get into all of the details. But this page that will be created for you does give you some other ideas and a little bit more context for getting started with your content library. So from here, these sections here, I can add more of these. So think of this left-hand column as essentially like your bookshelf. So if you want to add more books, so maybe you use this as units or topics, whatever that looks like, but we can add pages or add books to our shelf. So if I right click on this section, I can say new section, and now I can create a new book. If you want to think of it like a bookshelf, I've created a new book for unit one. So this is just like an online bookshelf. So from here in unit one, now pages are where you can add assignments, information, but another, it's like kind of the next level down in your file structure. So unit one, a page might have information that you want students to go do. So I can add, so if you click on a page, it opens up a new space for you to work. And then you can just type, this is like one big whiteboard essentially that you're typing on. And so as I'm typing on here, oh, maybe I want this to be, this top item here is your title. So maybe instead I'll use this to welcome students to my class. So from here, I can be typing. I can also insert tables, files, pictures. So it's kind of like a Word document. You probably have a little bit more flexibility. I can now type anywhere. So as I'm clicking, text boxes are being added anywhere on the page that I click. So in some ways it's like a Word document, but in other ways you have a little bit more freedom. So once you create whatever it is that you want on that page, you could be linking to other resources. You can actually draw on the screen. So whatever it is, that content that you want, if I click on that little caret again, I'll get back to where I can navigate to other pages. So you'll see that I'm still in unit one, and it took whatever it was that I titled this page and it put it over here in the list of pages. So if I want to build more pages within this book, I'm going to come over to this, the second column over, and I can right click. And now I can add a new page. So I can now have whatever, I can build whatever content I want on multiple pages for student and title them so that students can navigate this information. So this is a quick reminder that your content library is a place for you to deliver content to your students. So they are not able to write or change things in the content library themselves. So think of that as a place for you to deliver content to students, but they cannot engage with that or do anything or edit any of those documents themselves. So that will happen in their pages if you choose to use Class Notebook.